Good evening, or whichever time zone and time you are currently in. This is the audio video recording of my weekly blog. So today I will be talking a bit about YouTube, about working out, about programming, as well as my usual common themes, which is Reddit posts of the week, news of the week, as well as person of the week, which I hope you guys will find quite interesting. So without further ado, let's get started. So in terms of YouTube, doing an audio and video version of my blog has actually been extremely fun, and it helps, again, maintain consistency on my channel without having to overthink things and try and really plan out videos. But of course, I think there's really two parts of YouTube that two really essential components I think are incredibly important. The first is that in order to, I guess, generate new viewers, you really need to generate sort of a viral hit. Viral videos help garner new viewers and hence new subscribers. Whereas I feel like these sort of consistent posts are the ones that help sort of generate sort of your loyal following and the people who follow you consistently. So I guess the challenge for me now is to sort of figure out what has a good chance of generating virality. And even for the people who I guess are doing YouTube now, I guess that's like a huge question for them, which is why I thought this would be interesting to talk about in the blog. To me, I'm not really sure, but I do know that beyond the usual weekly blog videos, I need to perhaps plan out and script some videos as well. I expect these videos to be better produced with a planning phase, storyboarding of the shots, probably some rehearsal, first filmed with the iPhone, then maybe with the camera, followed by some many really cool editing and some cool B-roll. So for me, I'm still trying to figure out what my genre of video is. So I think, again, for starting YouTubers, that's something that all of us sort of need to figure out. But there's one general, there's one genre of video that has always fascinated me, which is a day in the life videos. The reason is because I really think that most people, not just kids, really have like sort of their 9-to-5 job and really have no idea beyond what their career is, what various careers beyond what their normal life actually looks like. For example, like as a science student, I don't really know what the career of a painter or maybe a filmmaker or a production artist would actually look like. And as a result, I think it would be extremely valuable to show a professional's work life and their career and what a work day actually entails. With that being said, COVID has made things really boring, and I'm talking about boring in terms of like from a career sense, in terms that most people are working from home. It's just not so easy to film and plan with somebody right now. I could probably just film myself first and make it try and look as interesting as possible, but that's not really as appealing to me. Unfortunately, I think this theme of day in life videos has already been quite saturated with students who sort of show the day in life as well as other professional workers. It's not congregated to one YouTube channel except for maybe one Japanese channel that I know. Also, some students have like a better advantage because of branding from their school, such as they go to Harvard, or other workers who have like unique professions and cool professions can just like film themselves and make it look really, really nice and super, super interesting. So I definitely don't have second mover advantage here. But I was thinking, what if actually just for fun, I could actually script something that's like super unrealistic and also make something that's like realistic as well. So the unrealistic making it, I guess, a little bit more funny, and the realistic part talking about sort of the more monotonous tasks that you have to do throughout the day for a career. Basically, I guess one thing that I was thinking of was, again, I guess maybe filming myself and cramming what I thought as a teenager, what university would be like, and cram that into like a day and maybe even a week and show like things like, oh, like an unrealistic day in university where I like, you know, like find love at first sight, or a day where I'm just partying all the time, or a day where I'm like super productive, or a day where I'm actually making food instead of ordering out. So I really think that it might be more interesting if I filmed it in sort of like a funny way. But I don't know. I guess like it might be a little bit inspired from like, I guess, the cinematography from Jackson Wang's video. I'm imagining it'd be interesting to do something like he did, but making it super, super cinematic from a student's perspective. I could even do like similar shots and do something like Hong Kong themed, I could even do like a parody of his video, except from a student perspective. But again, one of my friends actually brought up an interesting point, which was that if I don't shoot the montage well enough, it could look really boring or just like kind of like cheap looking. And I definitely agree. Like Jackson had like a full cast. He chose like a movie crew, like a film crew. He chose like the actors, and he like rehearsed a lot, first with a phone, then with a camera, then with professional cameras. So I think this is like a pretty ambitious like first attempt if I were to try and like do something that was like more cinema, like with more like sort of cinematography or something that's like sort of unrealistic and funny rather than sort of depicting like a realistic day in my life. However, I do think it would be something interesting to sort of try and go with. I guess one way I could deal with this is try and do combine sort of the YouTube vlog style with something more movie-esque, more cinema, with better like movie-esque planning and cinematography, and that way at least I would have a combination of the two. But again, like, it might be weird to transition between like a vlog style to a sort of a movie-esque cinematography style. Again, those are some of the thoughts that I was thinking about. I would also need people to agree with this. I would need like a cute girl to be like an actor for like if I were to like do some video where I was like sort of found love in first sight. That might also be a problem. By the way, my friend also took like that opportunity to say that I needed to like work out and change my appearance and like my hairstyle and stuff. I mean, I don't need to listen to her. I don't need to listen to anyone. I actually had a hair appointment actually a couple days ago. All right, well, I just got a haircut. I'm gonna try and grow out my hair, so I only cut the sides pretty much. But yeah, it's gonna be a long process to growing my hair longer. Yeah. But I think she does bring a good point. I do need to go to the gym. I feel like my energy has been a bit low playing basketball and stuff like that, and I think it'll really help with like sort of my mental energy as well. So because of that, I actually decided to read up on training programs and do some research on working out. And boy, is there a lot more content, and it's a lot more complicated than I originally thought it was. I think partially it's because like there's a lot of these like online programs where they're trying to like sell something to you, and they're kind of a mess. They're all over the place, and like it's really hard to understand, and unless like they're trying to like have these like paywalls for you to pay to help for you to like get the training program, stuff like that. And there's like a lot of advertisement out there. I guess like what I got out of it was that, number one, like it really doesn't matter what program you do at the very, very beginning. Like as a beginner, it doesn't matter what program you do, you're going to see improvements fairly quickly. So I think that's sort of the consensus there. And I do think that, like, I guess understanding the difference between like hypertrophy and strength training is really important. And I think hypertrophy is where like you try and like get big and have like more muscles, where strength training is about like pure strength. But I just sort of dabbled it in this week. I went to work out today, and I probably need to do some more research going into next week. But as a beginner, I think like it's just important to sort of get into a routine, get to the gym, and try and just follow whichever program you think is most interesting. But it'll be interesting for me to write a little bit more about that in the next week. So I think I will end it off here for this part of my weekly blog. Stay tuned in a couple of days for the release for the next part of my blog, where I will be talking a little bit about coding, about the Reddit post of the week, some of the news, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.